In today's video, I'm gonna explain you step by step of how you can get one of the most beautiful, if not the most beautiful armor set in Elden Ring. And yes, this is something pretty hard to obtain because you can get this armor set only and only after you will complete a series of tasks. So let's start. First things first, you have to join the Volcano Manor family. In order to do that, you have to travel to the Volcano Manor location. If you don't know how to do that, I'm gonna guide you very fast right now on the video. But if you have trouble finding the Volcano Manor, don't worry, I have a video on my channel how you can get there, a more complex video of how you can get there. Now, basically this is the path that you are seeing right now on the map. If something is too fast, you can slow down from YouTube. But if you already know how to be there, just fast travel to Volcano Manor. Join the family and get the key. That will be the first step that it's required to do. Talk with this lady, with Lady Tanit. And after a long discussion, you can join the Volcano Manor. I just cut out some parts of the dialogue. Again, I don't want to waste your time. I just want to show you how you can get that armor set very fast. And let me tell you something else. During this video, you're gonna get a lot of items, so be prepared for a lot of surprises if you are here for the first time in the Volcano Manor. Now, after just gonna talk with her, just go to the next room. I'm gonna show which one is that. Go to the to this path on the left, not the first door, not this one, because this one it will be blocked, the second one. And here you're gonna find some NPCs that you can talk with. I would advise you to talk with every single NPC that you're gonna find in that room. Depends, you can find two or three NPCs. For me are three, but they can be only two, depends where you are with the story. Then all you have to do is to grab the letter from the table. We're gonna keep grabbing those until we're gonna find the location that we need. First letter, it will be with a target that we have to defeat on the map. We have to invade someone's world. So from the first step, this one will be the easiest invasion that we can do. From the War Master Shack, just go up to the north and there you're gonna find your target. Go to the map, to the selected point on the map, because yes, you're gonna have a flag on your map. Just go there, invade. You're gonna see a sign on the ground and defeat this NPC. I think Istvan is the name, and you're gonna get a really cool armor set. That will be the first armor set that you're gonna get. But we are here for the long run, for the best armor set, for the best looking armor set that you can get. Then go back, talk with Lady Tanit, reload the area, and then grab the second letter. You will grab the second letter, and your next target, it will be near the capital entrance, or near the volcano, let's call it that. Right here, do rely, I don't know how to pronounce the name. Basically just travel from the Grand Lift of Dectus up to the flag location. If you don't know how to find this enemy, don't worry, I already have a video on my channel how you can find him. But basically you have to go to the for the flag that you're gonna see on the map. Rail the Idol is the name. And from this one you're gonna get a really awesome katana, but also some items, that veil, some arrows. And if you talk with Lady Tanit again after you will defeat the second target, you're gonna get the beautiful katana. I think the serpent katana is the name. Yes, the serpent bone katana, another rare item. And now finally reload the area again, this map, reload it again. You can talk with that knight that it's sitting on the chair, and you can get another letter from him, but also grab the red letter from the table. Now the complicated part will begin, because now we have to enter to the capital. In order to enter to the capital, we have to have two great runes, but probably most of you already know how to enter to the capital. And this is the path to the capital. I told you I'm gonna give you the quick guide, step by step, but not very detailed. Now, reach the Avenue Balcony, then reach the West Capital Rampart. From that, you have to go to the Earth Tree Sanctuary and defeat Godfrey. From that, you have to go to the Queen's Bedchamber, and here at the Elden Throne, it's a must to defeat Morgoth. After you're gonna defeat Morgoth, you're gonna get the Rolled Talisman. Go back to the Avenue Balcony and make your way right here where we are seeing now on the map, to the Forbidden Lands. If you know how to go to the Snow Region, it's perfect, because all you have to do is to fast travel to the Grand Lift of Rold, use the talisman that you just cut after you defeated Morgoth, and then go to the Zamor ruins, Zemir ruin, bro, I don't know how to pronounce the name, that ruins, and then we're gonna start from this location, from the ancient Snow Valley ruins, because the next flag is very, very close. That will be the last flag, and after we're gonna defeat this one, we're gonna get that beautiful, beautiful armor set, but bonus, you're gonna get an armor set. These are the items that are required, those talismans that you can enter to the snow area. But again, I'm very sure that most of you already know how to be in the snow area. Now, all you have to do is to follow me, because on this path that you are seeing right now, we're gonna find that next enemy that we have to defeat. We're gonna invade the next one. You're gonna see some fights here. You don't have to stay to fight. Just clear your path and read the sign. If you're gonna die in that battle, you will be teleported back again to this location. You don't have to go to the site of grace. So examine this symbol on the snow and then invade this NPC. The name is Juno Haslow. You're gonna get the Haslow oath if you don't attack in the first second, and then just defeat this guy. Not the easiest fight, not the hardest fight, I don't know. Just be aggressive because it has some heal. Don't let him heal because you're gonna waste some time. And after you're gonna defeat this guy, you're gonna get that beautiful, beautiful armor set, a whip. And also from this location, you can get another awesome armor set, something like the Maiden armor set or something like that from that shack. And if you go back to the Lady Tanit, you can get one of the most awesome talisman that you can have in this game. Okay, so we just defeated this enemy, the Haslow, and we're gonna get the whip, which I already have a really awesome video on my channel. We're gonna get the armor set, and now it's time for me to show you all the stats from that armor set, and also I'm gonna show you what I used to defeat that guy. This was my armor set. That was the sword, and as another bonus, beside all the items that you just got, this is the traveling maiden armor set you're gonna get from that location. I told you this video is with a lot of bonuses. Now let me show you how it looks. I told you, one of the most beautiful, beautiful armor set that you can have in this game, in my opinion. Correct me if I'm wrong, there are a lot of armor sets that are really nice, but at least the helm, oh my god, the helm, the armor, the headpiece, it's just unbelievable. These are the stats, and that's it. Thank you so much for watching. You can hit that like button, subscribe and share, press the notification bell for more videos like this. I daily post videos on my channel, a lot of them, so yeah, press the notification bell. Be safe and see you really soon. Bye.